improve your playing skills. Children love to play in group in this age. At the same time, they need to master certain good playing skills. You allow your child to play a group game. Once they finish playing the group game, you ask some questions to your child. Question number one. A child did not play well in a group. Did you encourage the child? Question number two. A child played well in a group. Did you encourage the child? Question number three. Did you tell anyone what to do while playing or what not to do while playing? This is a very important question because telling others or encouraging others while playing is different, but dictating others what to do is different. See, these may seem to be simple questions, but each question contains a skill hidden in it. You encourage your child to master those playing skills. Personal achievements. It is the duty of the parents and teachers to give the child a sense of pride. How can we do that? It's very simple. You give an age-appropriate simple task to your child. Let the child complete the task by himself or herself without your help. Once they finish, you appreciate the work of the child sincerely. This kind of simple activities will help your child to improve their self-confidence. Respect others' feelings. There are some external and internal signals that will indicate how you and me feel. If we are able to read the emotions of others from their face reaction and body language, it will help us to avoid so many problems. You give some situation to your child. For example, your friend is angry. Your brother is so sad. Some kind of situation like this. And ask your child, what kind of feelings or emotions they could find in their body language and face reaction. Let them speak about it. Afterwards, you ask your child, if you have the same feeling, what kind of emotions you will have? Let the child speak about those things and compare. And let the child learn to respect the feeling of other people.